Two of fish microorganism, that is microbiology lectures. Now here is what are the primary source of microorganism in food. The primary source of microorganism in food can be soil, can be water, can be air. In short, I am explaining about the soil, how the soil contaminates any type of plants or micro or animals we are having. If they are contaminated, it may lead to contaminate human beings also if we are not washing that thing before using, because soil enters inside human beings through if you eat the plant and whatever animals are there without washing it. Soil are the carriers, we can say that. In soil also aquatic environment, microorganism enter through wind, rain and other means, and it contaminates the plant water and thus the plant and the animal. What are the water that contaminates the microorganism? Water can also contaminate the microorganism. In water, soil and raw treated sewage and pollutant enters, and thus they contaminate the water body, and thus the contamination may enters the plants or animal. Then air can also contaminate the contaminates, and in it also there is microorganism, but due to quiet air can allow settling of microorganism, but the moving air brings in microorganism and keeps them suspended. Rain or snow removes the microorganism from air. Then the microflora of food processing facility. How can we reduce the microbial load in processing area? We can reduce it by it can be achieved by installing filtration of chemical treatment or heat or electrostatic precipitation unit. Filters prevent spread of microorganism from one part of plant to the other, and UV irradiation can also airlock the microorganism entering inside the food. How can we use the filtration? By filtering, something can reduce microbial load and chemical treatment also. Now, handling and processing. During handling and processing, safety measure should be followed. Then avoid use of contaminated water. Contaminated water can consist of microorganism and it may contaminate the food. Significance of microorganism in food. Microorganism associated with food are divided into three parts, that is, those that causing spoilage or undesirable change in food, those producing desirable change, and the producing disease. Now, based on extent of stability of microbial load, invasion food may be classified as perishable food, semi-perishable food, and stable food. Perishable food, example fish and meat. Semi-perishable food are potato and tomato, and stable food are cereal, flour and sugar. This was the lecture number 3. Now we will read further to lecture number 3 in the next class.